CS practical as well. So,
Yeah.
what are CS? We have now a special program to understand both LinkMX CTL concept and
Okay.
the DB2 concept.
Okay.
For that, what I did here is I developed a small, simple and easy login screen process.
Okay.
So for that, what I need is one table where I can store my user ID and password.
Okay.
This is what we need before only. Now, I have a login screen, the main screen program, which will be taking the user inputs.
Yeah.
ID and password, whatever he has given. Now, we need to validate it, whether the ID and password is right or wrong.
Okay.
So for that, I have a sub program, the validation program, which will take the inputs from main program, okay, using link, because it's a data process.
Okay.
Okay, using link, we will take the user ID and password and then query the table.
Okay.
Query the table to see if we got the right or wrong password details.
Yeah.
Now, since there are chances that the user may not type anything, there are chances that user may give a wrong input.
Okay.
So we need to go back and tell the user that there is an invalid ID, invalid password. So we need this program on hold.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
You understand me?
Yeah.
Then if you give the right user ID and password, now what happens? It's time to navigate.
Yeah.
It is by XCTL. We use it to call another screen.
Yeah.
After login screen.
Okay.
This is our XCTL example where we're gonna come out of this login part and go to the menu screen.
Okay.
Where user can choose the option of menu and then do his process.
Yeah.
Okay. So on all of the case, first start with the table part. Okay. So this is my table which I need to be creating. So table might be already there, but still we will. So I have a table. Let's I will select query.
Yeah.
There are no rows in this table.
Okay.
I will insert the table with my ID and password. Okay.
Okay.
Some random ID and password. I have an index for my login ID, so there will not be any duplicates. Okay. It's a general small rule that there should not be duplicate IDs. Fine. Login.
Yeah.
User ID and password. First step. At the beginning of when we join the project, we get the credentials, right? So this is how we got the credentials, assumed.
Yeah.
Now let's take the components into consideration. The first component is the screen components.
Okay.
So for that, I have mthread login. This is my screen, ISMLR. In that, I have some heading and couple of fields like user ID, password.
Okay.
These are my two simple fields on the screen. So
okay.
What we do, we take this name of the map set and name of the map. We need these two always in hand. Okay. Login screen. So just go and compile it and get the load. Step one by one step. Okay. Let's say we are doing it step by step. First, we need to deal with the login screen and its corresponding program.
Yeah.
Then we will deal with the subroutine.
Yeah.
Okay. First step, first compile the login screen. I got max. This is zero. Immediately go and check the layout. LCS, yes. Let's just set the case. Sira define map set with a map set name and the group R in your case. Press enter, system will say define successful, go back F3, install. Install also successful. Go back, clear the screen. CCI send map. We need that map name LGN map 1 and the map set which it belongs to and set login. Send. So we have the screen layout designed in this simple manner. Okay, not much fields, only few user ID password. Okay, and press enter. So we got colors because of our design only.
Yeah.
Now, once the login screen is done, we need the login program to interact with.
Yeah.
Okay. So here again, since it's a map, we only did PPT entry. Okay.
Okay.
We don't need anything because it's only the load part.
Yeah.
Go to login program. This program is very simple again. It only does the communication part. Okay, it only does the communication part, no logic here. So if it is length is 0, send empty map, first cap.
Yeah, okay.
If this length is not 0 and the user had entered an enter key or a clear key or an exit key, okay?
Okay.
So if he has entered an enter key, that is 200 process para, here it is. Whenever it is process para, first receive the data.
Yeah.
Okay. Validate the data. Okay. Of course, here I'm not validating. I'm doing something best way. So first validate the data whether user ID and password is not blanks.
Okay. Okay.
Sometimes user may just press enter. Okay.
Yeah.
So we just want to see whether he has given some data or not.
Okay.
If he has given data, then fine. We're gonna use it, the data. And we're going to pass the control to the subroutine.
Okay.
And we're going to pass the control to subroutine.
Okay.
And
we have used link only, right? To return the control back.
Right. Because we need to talk to the screen again.
Yeah. Okay.
Here in this case, we need to talk to the screen again because he may give wrong ID and password as well.
Yeah. Okay.
And my requirement of subroutine is to check ID password are correct or wrong. That's all. So we don't need to go for XCTL here.
Okay.
Data process.
Okay.
So we are first, generally we can do this in a single time only, but for our training practice, I did this for twice.
Okay.
First, I will check only user ID. Okay. User ID U. Then if ID is correct, then I would like to go and check the password P.
So while calling this validation program in the COM area, we are passing this user ID, right? First, if we are calling this for user ID validation.
Both cases, I'm taking a group, WS COM area group.
Okay, where it is having both credentials. Okay.
Yes, both ID, password, and this couple of switches as well, on and off switches.
Okay, okay.
Remember when we talked about subroutines in Bhopal?
Yeah.
Along with your input, you have to send output variable as well.
Yeah.
Okay, my output variable is yes or no of the valid switches.
Okay.
If password is valid, then I'll get back with yes here.
Okay.
So same with the user ID as well. So if I go over our COM area, see here, I'll be sending user ID, password, whether to validate user ID or whether to validate password.
Okay.
Yes or no, and what switch you are validating.
Okay.
So basic way, input and output both should be sent for subroutine always.
Yeah.
Okay. Now come back here. So this particular link statement, I can do it only one time and check the ID and password both at a time.
Okay.
But like I told you, just for our practice purpose, I'm sending ID and then passwords separate times.
Okay.
Okay, so that I can show you better way twice.
Okay, yeah.
Now, in case if ID and password are correct, then you can go for your calling the menu program.
Okay.
XCTL menu program. Clear?
Yeah. What is this DFHBMUNP to user ID A?
This is is used when, like, attribute field, you remember A field?
Yeah, okay.
A field is used to change the properties of the field, okay?
Okay.
When I was testing it, okay, when I was testing it, I did not return this line. Okay?
Okay.
So I will get this message, login successful, and the field of user ID will change to unprotect now.
Okay.
In the above step, okay?
Yeah.
Made it as protect.
Okay.
Because when I'm checking password, the user ID should be protected.
Okay.
Even if user has given wrong password, we will send that please type password, not again user ID.
Okay.
But to change the field properties, we use attribute field.
Yeah.
That there are predefined variables in your copybook, DFH, BMS, CA.
Okay.
When I was doing the test setup of this program, I used these keywords as well.
Okay.
In our case, it's not required because by the time when XCTL is called, the program will be terminated. These statements will not execute anytime.
Okay.
Just later, if I want to practice something, I left it like this instead of deleting them.
Okay.
I already know once we call this one, this will be not executed.
Okay.
Understood so far?
Yeah. So if you are moving, if in case of error only, we'll be moving that -1 to length field, right?
No. That's what I was about to tell you. So apart from this normal way of understanding the code, there are two tricks that we use in the program.
Okay.
One of the main trick is to use the low values to clear the junk data from the previous transaction.
Okay.
Don't use spaces. Okay.
Yeah, okay.
Low values are your hexadecimal spaces, which consumes lesser bytes.
Okay.
Don't use spaces. That is the first trick.
Yeah.
Second trick is when you are sending a map, by default, using IC, that is called insert cursor.
Yeah.
Your cursor will be on your first input field.
Okay.
But in your screen, there might be 3 or 4 fields as input. Okay. Not only one, 3 or 4 might be an input.
Okay.
So, for example, if the requirement is to give 2 fields as input,
okay,
user has given only 1 input and press enter.
Okay.
Now, what I need to do, I need to tell the user saying that please give the second input as well, right?
Yeah.
And what the best thing we can do here is place the cursor on the second input field dynamically.
Yeah.
So, whichever field you want to place the cursor, you should use this -1 before sending.
Okay.
This is called cursor positioning technique.
Okay.
Whenever we say cursor positioning technique, static, it is IC.
Okay.
It is by default. Whenever you send map, always it will look into IC nature only.
Yeah. Okay.
The next nature is dynamic. So whenever you say dynamic, we use this length field for dynamic process.
Okay.
Dynamic positioning, not process, positioning.
Okay.
Okay. And the third one is relative, where you do not have a screen, you need to use send cursor concept.
Yeah.
Okay. That is very rare. We don't need to look into that, but it's very rare to send without any map.
Okay.
So basically, if you give a blank screen to user, he doesn't know what to do.
Okay.
We don't do that.
Yeah.
Okay. So this program has only simple nature to take the input of user, first thing.
Yeah.
Check the ID and password with first auditing yourself whether he has given or not.
Okay.
If he has given, very good. Go and check the table.
Okay.
Like this, link command. If he has not given, if he has already spaces or low values, because we already moved it to low values, right?
Yeah.
It's as a space or is in low value, we want to send an error message. Please type your user ID to your message variable. Okay, this is part of your screen design only.
Yeah.
And tell the cursor where to be placed.
Okay.
And second thing, similar example, if your password has been blank by some reason.
Okay.
Then we're going to tell, please type your password and place the cursor at the right place.
Okay.
That is cursor positioning technique part.
Okay.
Got it? 2 points understood?
Yeah, understood.
Right. Go back and compile this program now. yes. So see, this program which I'm talking now is just a normal program. It doesn't have DB2, okay?
Okay, okay.
So we're gonna compile with translation process, okay? Most yeah. people will get tricky understanding here. Whichever program has DB2, only that program should go with your bind process and everything.
Yeah.
Okay? Even it is subroutine, go it with subroutine only. Do not make your main program assume as DB2.
Oh, okay, okay.
Subprogram is DB2, not main program.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so this is one of the best example. This main program is not having anything related to DB2.
Yeah.
The subroutine is all about DB2 only.
Okay.
Okay. So now I have compiled it. I got zero there. What I need to do here is go to CSS environment.
Okay.
Zero. Find program yeah. with the program name and you as the group name.
Okay.
Define successful, F3, go back and install. Okay. Done. Now what you need to do, go for PCT entry straight away. Do not forget this. Don't go out from here.
Yeah.
Okay. LGN1 is my favorite. So this trial will trigger this program.
Okay.
Enter, define successful, F3 and install. So this is PCT required for programs which are need to be triggered. Okay.
Yeah.
Press enter, install successful. So we have the login program which has both PPT and PCT entry with LGN1 as a plan ID.
Yeah.
Now the sub program. Okay. Then go for subprogram. So subprogram has very simple again. Okay. The yeah. concept of login is already known. That's why these programs are very simple.
Okay.
We have basic copybooks.
Yeah.
It's a DB2 program. Now I have DFH com area receiving the data as it is in same particular mapping 1-to-1. Okay.
Yeah.
Now in my main para, I just check whether it is for U or P. Check for user or check for password. Okay. If it is for user, I'm gonna run a where condition on the given user ID.
Yeah.
It's successful. I found it, so I'll be moving yes to my output variable. If okay. I do not find, it is no.
Okay.
Similarly, I have an SQL query to check user ID and pass together in AND condition.
Okay.
We are not checking only password, we should check always with user ID only.
Okay.
That's the general. So we can do this program for only running this query, but like I told, we will do it for our practice purpose.
Okay.
Okay, so we have SQL code yes, if both are successfully done. If not, system will send back N.
Yeah.
Okay. In this program, there is only one CSS command that to return.
Yeah, okay.
Nothing else required here in this program. So we will close this straight away. Subroutine is a DB2 program, okay?
Yeah.
We need our bigger JCL to do it.
Okay, okay.
So member name. So we have the DBRM, the copy book of DB2 required, copy leaves if required, load module is required, your input. Yeah. Okay? So okay. submit this one. These instances are prepared by me only. So we know all these things, how they work.
Okay. Include that sys library, DS and CLI, that is for what we are giving?
They need it, okay. Generally, it's your part of your link lib, okay. When you are including the running, compiling your programs, DB2 programs,
yeah.
you have to add the load modules of DB2, okay.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
That you did not do it by normal way here. We did it in our COBOL compiler link.syslmod. Okay.
Okay,
this
okay.
is nothing but overriding only. Okay.
Okay.
This is nothing but overriding. We are overriding with the system related load modules.
Oh, okay. Okay.
You will find something like DSN, HLI, DSN, ELI, and DSN, CLI. Like this kind of subroutines required for different level of compilations.
Okay. Okay.
So for CSS related, we need CLI. For normal DB2, it will be HLI, I guess. Remember if it is.
Okay, okay.
got zero in my pre-compilation, and I just need to do my bind, and we know how it works.
Okay.
Okay, so bind package, I have given the member name as like this. We can differentiate our name as program name also, okay?
Okay.
So when I was testing, I was not giving any program name. I'm using the system only.
Okay.
So done. I got my plan. So go back to your CSS environment and start doing the entry part. So here what entries are required, Sridhar, define.
So one more doubt, actually we are not the last run JCL, we are it is not needed, right?
Not required. Why? We are not going to execute through JCLs.
Okay. So we have done the translation JCL is not required, the kick translation job.
That's part of our pre-compilation and translation only. So if I want to show you the spool 3.8, sorry, not 3.8. So the bind pre-compile part, if you see here, these are the steps I did. So pre-compilation, then followed by translation, then compilation and link edit.
Okay, so this is the only one job we submitted now, right?
Finally, one job is enough.
Okay, and then the bind step. Okay.
Yes, so if you see our notepad also, I have very clearly showed you that if it is COBOL CSS DB2, you will have only one job to do the first pre-compiling, remove the DB2, then translation, remove the CSS, then compile and link edit, get the load and DBRM. This is our first output you got.
Okay.
Then you just need the job J2 to do the bind process to create package and plan.
Okay.
Our notes are very much thing that you need to refer for this fundamentals. Okay.
Yeah.
And again, it's very easy as well to remember them, not to refer always. So we are defining this subroutine, press enter,
Come
back and install.
Okay.
Here again, remembering part, this is a sub program without any screen. Okay. So we don't need this with PCT entry. PCT entry is only enough. Okay. There is no TRAN to trigger it.
Since it is a main program only, we have the TRAN.
Okay. Generally, for main program only, you'll write JCL, right?
Yeah.
Same concept. Now let's go for after login screen.
Okay.
So once I log in, I should get some link screen, right?
Yeah.
I have given as menu set. This is my last final screen of my CSS designs.
Yeah.
And menu set 1. This is the screen name. Okay. Once we compile, we just need a PPT entry, not more than that.
Okay.
We compile. Go back.
So you haven't put a transaction ID for the menu screen. That is why we need only a PPT entry.
For maps, there will be no transaction IDs. It's not program. It's a map.
Yeah. But for the menu set program, we need directly. If you want to go to the menu set, we need a transaction ID, right?
Yes, because this is a screen program. Every screen program will have a TRAN ID. But whether it is called through user interaction directly, or the directly program is called by XETL, is the two ways.
Okay.
Trans are used directly by your online front ends, Java .NET transaction as well. They don't come with menu line login, right?
Okay.
The logins are done with .NET framework only.
Okay.
If it is the customer is only using CSS, then we do login here.
So, you have told me, right, the PCT entry is not required. Why it is so?
Because PCT is required for programs. This is the map set.
Okay.
It will trigger the program, not the map set, right?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, understood.
Too many components, just follow the lead. Then we have the program. Okay.
This program
also don't have any DB2, so I'll compile it in normal way. Okay. This is the menu screen. Good. Then define program. So program name. enter. Okay, define successful, install successful. Then I need to define the trial for this. So for the trial, I need to see what was the trial I should use. Trials, menu one.
Okay.
And install. So while installing, remove this program, you'll get error.
Okay.
Done. So if I remember, I have given everything except one. Okay. So menu program, we have PPT entry and PCT entry with MNU1 as the TRAN ID.
Okay.
If you see here, only the programs, the main programs will have these PCT entries.
Okay.
App sets, subprograms and other components we don't need. Okay.
Okay.
So far so good. We have given everything except to one, that is the plan part.
Okay.
S1304PL. Now this is required the RCT entries.
Okay.
The entry we've seen before, but now RCT is for first time.
Yeah.
So let's go for CSS environment and then I'll show you this CIDA command. Define. So what we are trying to do is this two. This is already done. Okay. This is already done. How do I show you? I show it in a real way. So first hyphen db ag stop db2. I'm just stopping the db2 environment. You see here CSS db2 attachment facility is in standby.
Okay.
The connection is to be there before only. Okay.
Okay.
So now CSS db2 subsystem is not active. Whenever both systems are active, automatically it will be connected because of the admin setup. Okay. Luckily we have this setup so that we are doing this good program now.
Okay.
Would have not have this setup, I would have just given in theory only.
Okay.
So we'll start running the db2 again. So when system boots the db2, one of the option it has to do is to connect with the CSS as well. So your admin will do it, we do not do. This is called attachment facility. So for this also I have, we'll first see the message, then we'll go back and show you one of the diagram. Happened? Did it stop? I started between stop or what?
The stop complete, it is showing.
It's still going on.
Yeah.
I was little bit hasty with arming the services, so now it's completely stopped. I'm using very older version of db2.
Okay.
It is the very old version. Now we are doing with 12, I guess, even 13, I guess.
Okay.
So it's very old. I cannot update. I'm not that skilled. If I am very skilled, I would have been somewhere else.
Now it started. It is showing a starter.
Yeah. Earlier I just gave start before it stops properly. Come up, man. Okay, so see here below, last message, CSS db2 has connected. Okay, this is what we need to see.
Okay.
I have a very good, pretty good diagram for our look and feel as well. Also, that is also my one of my painting skills over there. Handling our next topic. This is file processing. Right, this would be the best one. Right. Okay. Okay, so this is how the diagram looks like. We have the terminals on the front end, left side. Okay,
yeah.
They're gonna need to interact with the application program.
Okay,
it has to go with always CSS environment only.
Okay,
so application program want to talk to terminal, it has to tell to CSS. Application program want to talk to data set, it has to tell to CSS.
Yeah.
Application program want to talk to DBT also, it need to talk to CSS only. Okay.
Yeah.
Your CSS is your interface, your courier service, which will communicate the trans data to different environments here. Okay. Data sets are all in ZOS. DB2 installation is also ZOS, but the connection should be there with something called CSS attachment facility.
Yeah. Okay.
Only then your data communication channel process. There are three channels, DB2, data sets and terminal. Okay. There is one more channel that will come under CSS itself. Temporary memories.
Okay.
That is another place where we need to look into. Okay. Now let's go back to our example here. So what we are trying to do is CDOT define DB2E entry part. Okay. To LGN2 group R and press enter. What I need to tell here is what transaction ID it has to be linked with. Okay. Then come down and give the plan name here.
Okay.
This is what tricky part to remember. In earlier, all the define and install, we just did not change anything here.
Yeah, yeah. So LGN2 is the new transaction ID, right, for the menu program.
Now, this is what I told. The entry ID is another thread. Okay. Another process thread, which will keep track of DB2 part.
Okay. Okay.
Your transaction ID will keep part only on CSS.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, which is linking with your screen part.
Yeah, okay.
Now, from the program, it has to go and touch another subsystem, right?
Okay.
So, diagram helps you. That would be best. So, now it has to go and touch the CS DB2 system.
Okay, yeah.
This one is held by your TRAN ID. Okay, let's say like that.
Yeah.
And this one is held with your entry ID of DB2 connections.
Okay, okay.
Got it? In that, yeah. We'll have provided the plan name. So, when DB2 has the plan name, it knows what is the program, what is the package, what is the query, everything is there in the plan.
Yeah, okay, okay.
So we just give the plan name, press enter again, second time, F3 and install.
Okay. Yeah.
We get unsuccessful because this is there from long time, okay? DB2 entries are only uniqueness.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
So whatever we did for program and other things, they can be duplicated because given an application, there will be same program name, same package, but map set names, which should be separated by the groups.
Okay.
But when we are trying to talk about DB2, DB2 is having only single entity.
Yeah.
So it should be not be duplicated there. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, anyway, we don't need to worry about this one. This is an internal part. We never know as a developer because this will done by the CSS admin only.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
We'll never need to worry about. Then define T as well, the link up part, link T entry ID LGN2 with the actual transaction ID.
Oh, okay, okay.
This is also required again, but this is also you can forget about it because it's not known to the developer side.
Oh, okay, okay.
This is also DB2 TRAN because it's already there, okay.
Okay, okay.
I'll just go back, clear out this part because this is already set up long time, many times.
Yeah, so DB2T we just gave, DB2T we gave to link this DB2 entry and the transaction ID, right?
Right, so two things, DB2E. Okay, we already told this, but we'll just remember this is for plan ID.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Okay, so DB2T is to connect the entry and the TRAN.
Okay, okay.
Okay. So we are just linking in the security part of connections, which transaction ID can trigger these threads.
Okay, okay.
So the last part is very much simple to see what we have in our group.
Okay.
So these are the components we have in our group where we have some programs. These are the programs we have now. Okay, one is a login program, another menu program and validation program, all three. Then we have the login ID, transaction ID, entry IDs, required menu ID as well. Two screens, one menu set, one login screen. So we have all the components in place, F3. Let's start the game in a normal mode. GN1. So when I give LGN1, I should be seeing my screen like this. And if I give Anil 1, 2 and then press enter, my control has placed in a password position, that is by 2 minus 1. And asking me to type the password. And 2, 3. So when I log in, I should go to some other screen. Got it? Now F3, we came back to our main screen again. Because in my menu program, I have given XETL to come back. Got it? Now this is very fast to complete. We will do it in debug mode. And see what exactly in our notes, what exactly on the screen. So start with login ID. So program got initiated with the program name, some random task number, length is zero. That's what we just need to see. First transaction. So send the map. Map has been sent. Response is normal. Return the transaction ID, LGN1. This time I have a length of 19. But it's as of now blank because we're going to use COM area to place the data for subroutine. So we are just giving a blank space of 19 length. That will change my COM area length. Ultimately, my pseudo logic will work. Program terminated, task terminated, left with my screen. So I'll type Anil ID and Anil password. The field is in dark position, so we cannot see. Press enter, program initiated second time with the length of 19. Receive map, it has received my ID and password. So look at the hyphens as well, underscores as well. We need to remove them by using inspect replace option. Famous statement in any online screen program. So most of the, some of the screen developers who know this point, on the screen itself, they'll keep it blank. They don't keep underscores as a place to type. But 90% you will see the screen with underscores where users should notice where to type. Program, you have to replace these hyphen underscores with spaces.
So before typing, I have seen in your program inspect replacing this underscore by the spaces. So before typing, we should give this inspect.
Before you start doing any auditing, anything, remove these underscores and keep it as space. So we received the map normally. As the program, what it will do, it has to now go and call the subroutine. That is the link command. So in the link command, this is my COM area data with ID, user ID. Assuming it, this is output variable, assuming it has no for the time being. Asking the subroutine to validate only user ID. So when I press enter, second program got, validation program got initiated under this transaction ID. Program got initiated, press enter. System is about to run the transaction SQL query. This is for SQL. Press enter. We got SQL code 0 there. That's what we can see in this backend. So this is done. Press enter. You are returning back. Your subroutine done its work. Program got terminated. Your subprogram got terminated. Control came back to your main program, which was waiting. With an yes option, assuming that, the user ID is valid. Now to show you for second time, I'm just running the same part with password now. I'm assuming the password is wrong and asking the system to check the password as well. How the system will behave? It will first initiate the sub program. Main program is still there. See the COM area. I got the data here. This is DFH COM area. Press enter. Second time, the query is going to run for second time. We got SQL code 0 in your second scenario as well.
Okay.
Written in the control bag. Program, subprogram got terminated. Written with yes, saying that both are true.
Yeah, okay, okay.
So whenever I'm running link, okay, let's go back to the notepad and see what we have written ourselves on the link part. So whenever I say link, this is used to send the control to subprogram, very true.
Yeah.
Control will be coming back to the main program, exactly what happened here, okay?
Yeah, okay, okay.
In this case, main program will be waiting.
Waiting, okay, okay.
Okay, and used for data processing, auditing kind of story.
Okay, okay.
Now let's go and press enter. Since ID and password both are true,
yeah,
we need to navigate to the next screen.
Yeah, okay.
So press enter. XCTL calling the program now.
Yeah.
Okay. Now look at what happens first part. Program terminates. Your main program got terminated here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, when XCTL is used, the main program will be terminated. Press enter. And the subprogram start initiating as itself as the main program now.
Okay, okay.
Okay, in earlier linked part, it was initiation first, then the subprogram termination, then control come to main program.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
In XCTL, first main program got terminated.
Okay.
And then started the subroutine. Now what happened here is, you left the train.
Yeah.
Okay, you left the train. This person has catch up the seat.
Yeah, okay.
So what he'll do, he will send his screen, okay, he will be seated there.
Yeah.
While returning at some destination for snacks, he has to leave his kerchief over there, not yours.
Okay, okay, okay.
The process started with yours.
Yeah.
But it now go with his, right?
Yeah, okay.
Program terminated, task terminated, and he left with his own screen with menu as transaction ID.
Okay, okay.
Now again, I'll show you this XCTL story by pressing F3. Program initiated, calling the main program now back the login screen.
Yeah.
How, what happens? First, this menu program will be terminated.
Yeah.
Then the login program should initiate.
Yeah. Okay.
Menu program terminated, login program initiated. And now when I'm returning this login program,
yeah,
I will return with this particular train ID.
Okay, okay, yeah.
Right, program terminated, task terminated, and back to the same screen.
Okay, okay.
Link and XCTL, you should not have doubt. Okay. Whatever the steps I told you, it is exactly what happening here as well.
Yeah, okay.
Second thing, DB2 part, do not worry. It doesn't have any newness or anything to extra learn when you are doing a DB2 program with CSS also.
Okay, okay.
Your queries will not affect, your include statements will not affect. There is nothing to, you need to remember respect to CSS.
Okay, okay.
That's the two things that you remember. On the CSS front, RCT entries are required, which will be done by your admin only.
Okay, okay.
Only the plan name he has to link up with proper way.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, any doubts?
No, maybe I'll go through the recording once and then if any doubts, I'll ask you tomorrow.
Right, right. No issues. You can come back with the same doubts. Yeah. I have, there are two more things that we need to go with. One would be the part of handling the data on file.
Yeah.
And queues. One would be handling the errors.
Yeah.
Okay. There are very much reason that you'll get an error always in CSS from developer side only.
Okay.
So we need to know how to deal with the very common errors, which is very feasible to look into.
Okay. Okay.
That we will see it in the next theory class. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Any doubts so far?
No. No.
Okay. I would request you to go with all the recordings at once.
Okay.
Okay. Because these are all we know. Visa means nothing but read and write only.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Queues are also read and write only. The only thing is, this is stored in ZOS. This is stored in CSS.
Oh, okay, okay.
So this will be very, very simple topics only.
Okay.
Like I told now, only the first part will take a lot of time.
Okay.